It's a common drug used to control type 2 diabetes, but increasingly people are taking it off-label to live longer and prevent age-related diseases. We're not talking about the highly popular Ozempic that's become a weight loss wonder. Tonight we're looking into metformin. It controls blood glucose levels, and scientists are studying whether it could also help protect against cancer and dementia and even prevent strokes. So what are the risks, and should we all be taking it? For more, let's bring in endocrinologist Professor Katherin Samaras at Sydney St Vincent's Private Hospital tonight. Thank you for joining us, Professor. You're with the Garvan Institute and conducting a trial right now using metformin to prevent dementia. What can you tell us about this study?
We're undertaking a 3-year intervention in people who have mild cognitive impairment. So they're already people who are losing a little bit of memory or a little bit of function, that they've noticed some changes in the way they're thinking. And we're looking at metformin and its impact on aspects of brain aging. How is the brain aging in people on metformin versus those people who are not, is the question that we're asking. We're interested in looking at changes within the brain structure, so using MRI, functional MRI, measuring changes in brain volume, looking at stroke changes, mini stroke changes, looking at amyloid burden. Amyloid is a protein deposited in the brain that damages brain function and is associated with Alzheimer's disease. We're also interested very much in how metabolism, because metformin is a metabolic drug, how metabolism changes with metformin to slow down brain aging, inflammation, changes in the gut microbiome.
Are you hopeful?
Extremely hopeful. We showed a couple of years ago that people with diabetes on metformin had an 80% reduction in incident dementia over a period of 6 years. So we thought we could use this in people who don't have diabetes and see if we could slow down brain aging and prevent dementia. It's 70 years old and it's off patent, so it's incredibly cheap. With 70 years of safety data, we know that this medication is safe. It's been used in pregnancy, in children. So there are very few concerns about using it more generally.
There's a Harvard scientist, though, Professor David Sinclair, who argues this can reverse ageing to a certain extent. He says it's such low risk, it's cheap, you could potentially be preventing dementia, cancer, inflammation of the body that leads to age-related disease. Why not take it? Everyone should include it in their diet. Do you disagree?
Look, I think it's a very interesting space where we need more evidence. It's certainly a low risk of harm. It's certainly very cheap. Is it going to add benefit? If you're not doing the good things like Dr. Sinclair does, because he's very active and he eats well, he does all these other things, we don't know if you're doing all the right things. Is it going to add any benefit? I'm not so sure, because if you're already doing the good things, then it's probably not going to add an iota of difference. We don't have any data in human beings that it reverses aging. There are some lovely studies that have really promoted science by extending the life expectancy of worms and rodents, but that doesn't mean we can extrapolate or extend those findings to humans. Metformin has been shown to have benefits in other areas apart from aging. For example, as an add-in to some cancer therapies, there have been shown to be benefits. So I think it's a very interesting drug that we need to explore its fullest benefit, but I think we shouldn't go off without the evidence that it helps humans in lots of other ways.
Thank you so much, Professor Katherin Samaras, for your time tonight.